Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to discuss about the topics inner classes and array list. Okay, before getting into the details of today's topic, we'll start with a brief recap. The previous class we were discussing about interfaces and object cloning. We will take few minutes to recollect all the things that we have discussed in the previous class. All the answers will be objective type, one or two words. You type your answer in the chat box. Okay. First question. Interface is used to achieve dash. Abstraction, very good, Leela, Satvika, Srivarshini. Joseph, abstraction, Bharat, very good. Sriya, abstraction, loose coupling, very good. Harish, any other benefit that we get out of interface, abstraction is the top answer. Okay, that is good, fine. Multiple inheritance, yes. So we have received many answers. We use inheritance in Java programming to achieve abstraction. Okay, abstraction is the main objective. You can achieve multiple inheritance. You can have loosely coupling. Also, we can provide security because by abstraction, we try to hide some details, right? Only the necessary thing we show to the outside world. So your answer abstraction is exactly correct. Second question. By default, interface fields are dash, dash, and dash. In the interface, we can have fields and method. By default, they are your answers. Public, static, final. Leela Satvika has given the answer. Very good. Bharat Kumar C. Shivaranjani, your answer is also correct. Harish, good. Sriya, good. Priyanka, good. Bharat, good. Okay, I've got all the three answers. By default, the interface fields are public, static, and final. One more additional question on this area. Interface is similar to class, right? It has got both the fields method. Can an interface have a constructor? Can an interface have constructors? No. Yes. Okay. Thank you. Many answers. Many are responding. Very good. The next question. Interface extends another interface. True or false? True. No. Sindhu, you have given answer no. Interface can extend and another interface. Very good. I get many answers. Thank you for your responses. An interface can extend and another interface. An interface cannot implement another interface. Okay. A class can extend and another class. You know very well that is inheritance. Similarly, interface can also take the features of existing interface. So interface can extend and another interface. A class can implement interface. Okay. interface is abstract. We cannot create object and use. The any class which is using the interface need to implement the interface. Very good. Your answer is correct. The answer for the interface extends another interface. True or false? It is true. Very good. The next question. We have discussed about at override annotation. This is good practice. Using at override annotation in Java programming is a good practice. We also have discussed what are the benefits you get out of using override. Now you tell me when at override annotation is used in Java programming. While overriding. Very good. Only Harish has responded. Any other answers? It's used when we use overriding in Java programming. Other than Harish, others? What is the benefit we get out of using at override annotation? Your answer is correct. The answer is while overriding a method in subclass, we make use of overriding. What is the benefit? You can give the answers in one or two words. Benefit. Improves readability. Very good. So when anyone sees the program, you can understand that particular path is going to override a method which is present in the superclass. Okay. Improves readability. Saplika, good. Any other answer? Used to prevent error. Okay. If you are using at override and the part of the code doesn't override any method, so you will get a warning from compiler that you are not overriding. Okay, so it will help you to prevent the error. Priyanka, your answer is also correct. You should know, because for giving your answers in one or two words, you should be able to explain. Okay, justify your answer. Okay, make a note of it in your notebook. The next question. Interface can't be instantiated, but can make reference of it referring to the object of class that is implementing it. True or false? Think and answer. We all know interface cannot be instantiated. Because it is abstract. Is Satvika true? Priyanka has given answer true. Joseph Priyo is present today in the class. No reply from him. Harish, others, those who are not participating at all, can try. The answer is going to be either true or false. I am waiting for some more responses. Think and tell. If anything is abstract, you cannot instantiate. Interface is an abstract. But you can make use of the variable, which is of interface type, to hold the reference of the class that is implementing it. True, Deepika. The answer is true. Very good. Interface can be instantiated, but can make reference of it. It refers to an object of its implementing class. Okay, the answer is true. You should remember this. Okay, while writing the key points about interface, we have written this point. when you read the content from the PowerPoint shared with you, you recollect this point. Next question. The clone method takes much extra processing task for creating exact copy of an object. True or false? Harish says false. Very good. Any other answer? Yes, Leela Satvika, Varshini, PST, Shivaranjani, Priyanka. Very good. Your answers are all correct. They all have replied with false. A clone method takes much extra processing task for creating exact copy of an object. This is false. It takes a minimum processing time task when compared to using dash operator. Dash keyword in another question. Usage of clone method takes less processing task processing time less than using the dash keyword. What is the other way we use to create an object? The basic way of creating the object is done with help of new. Very good, Bharat Kumar. New takes extra processing task, right? Time. So we go with clone method if you want to have exact copy of an object which is already existing. Your answer is correct. The previous class we have discussed about clone in detail, right? You cannot achieve this easiness without some extra work in your code. Can anyone tell me, if you watched, what are all the extra work we have carried out in our program where our own class needs to make use of clone method? Again, I repeat, to make use of clone method in our program, what is the extra work we have done the program? Think, okay, clonable implement. Okay, if you want to create copy of an object, you first define the class. That particular class need to implement the clonable interface. Very good. Number one, Bharat, your answer is correct. What are the other work we need to do? Implementing clonable interface. One. You all know whenever we make use of a method, if it is not supported, it will give some errors. Okay. In order to stop the error, what we have to do? Okay, you need to make use of try, catch, throw block. What is the type of exception we need to handle? We have to include exception handling part in our code. What is the type of exception need to be handled? Exception handling block need to be included. What is the type of exception? Yes, very good. Clone not supported exception. Satvika, your answer is correct. A clone not supported exception need to be handled. In order to handle this, the clone method makes use of throws keyword, right? In exception handling, we have a five keyword: try, catch, throw, throws, finally. If you feel that your method may throw some kind of exception, that can be represented in the method header, right? Using the throws keyword. So you'll be handling the error, flow not supported exception. Very good. The clone method of dash class is used in clone an object. Next question. Clone method of dash class used to clone an object. Harish has also given object. Very good. In Java, object is the super class for all the classes, whether it is user defined or inbuilt in the class hierarchy. Clone method comes under the object class. The clone method of object class is used to clone the object. Very good. The answer is correct. Now we will start with the topics for today's discussion: inner classes and array list. If you want to enrich your knowledge in the Java programming, you should be strong in the fundamental concepts that we have studied in the previous class. Right? We are studying inner class. So you should know what is class, how it is defined in Java programming, how you can create a class that is more secure. Okay. Array list. You should be thorough with the basic array concepts. Okay, to understand the array list. So whenever the key terms comes, we will have a brief question and answer session on the fundamental topics. Okay. We'll start with inner class. You can easily understand from the name itself, inner class. In Java, just like methods and variables, class too can have another class as its member. When we define a class, till now we have included methods. You can have any number of methods. We have included variables, fields. Okay, you can have any number of fields, variables in the class. When we write a Java code, initialization of the variables we use in our class is very, very important. If we miss initialization of some variables, the program may give inaccurate results or some garbage values. Example, when you write a program that finds sum of n numbers, you declare a variable. So you include a field sum and you initialize it to 0, right? If you miss this 0, the value from 1 till n will be added up with some garbage value in the location, right? In the memory location. So initialization is important. So if you have any variables need to be initialized to default values or any special values, we do it with help of constructor, right? So class contains method, field, constructor. If you want your variable to be initialized to default values, default constructor can be used. If you want to have any special value, you can use your own parameterized constructor to initialize. Similar to this members, you can also have another class as its member. Okay. While discussing about inheritance, when a class extends class, we have said it represents dash relationship. What is that relationship? What is that relationship? It's a relationship. Harish, good, right. When a class extends on another class, we say it is it's a relationship. When a class contains an another class, okay, what is the relationship? You have a class inside and another class as a member. Is a relationship. In a relationship. Okay, I get many answers. You see, already we have discussed for inheritance. Vishnu Hasan has given in a right in a relationship. It is your task, right? You have to find and tell me what is the type of relationship, right? It is your assignment. Writing class within another class is allowed in Java, right? Till now we have not included any class, okay, inside a class. Now using inner classes, you can write a class inside and another class. This is allowed. The class written within class is called nested class. You would have come across this term nested, right? Nested if else, right? Similarly, when you have a class inside and another class, we call as nested class. The class that holds the inner class is called outer class. Okay, you create a class, and inside the outer class you declare another class, right? The class which contains the inner class is called outer class, right? Here is the simple syntax to understand how the inner class can be used in Java. You all know the syntax for the class creation: class keyword followed by a space followed by the class name. So the class name you use should be a meaningful name. You keep a short and meaningful name because you'll be using name in different places of your code. If it is short, it will be easy for you to use. Outer demo convention, you should remember: class name should start with the capital letter. If it contains the second word, the first letter should start with the capital letter, right? This we call as mixed case. So inside the outer demo, you have another class, a class inner demo. This is the syntax for using inner classes in Java. Very simple, right? Along with this, you can have your own fields, methods, right? Constructors. We are discussing about inner class. So here the syntax for defining an inner class is given in the syntax. Why should we have inner class? What are the advantages you get out of using the inner classes in Java? Class inside a class has a relationship. Very good. Harish has given the answer. Just now I have noted, he has given has a relationship. The advantages: nested class represent a special type of relationship. That is, it can access all members of outer class, including the private. Okay, the class which is called inner can have privilege to access all the members of the outer class. Nested class are used to develop more readable and maintainable code because it logically group class and interfaces in one place only, right? So far we have discussed you can create any number of classes, you can place them in packages. Okay, packages, you know, concept packages are nothing but just got collection of logically related classes and interfaces. When you want to make use of the features available in some class, you import the package to your code and you use. Here what we do, we try to group, right, the classes which are closely related in one place. Okay, because class inside and another class, logically group classes. Code optimization is also achieved by the way of using the inner classes. We need to use less code. if we use inheritance during the execution of the program, even though you have flexibility, efficiency will be less, because when you want to have features of an already existing class, when you compile your code need to be compiled with the already existing code inherit the class, and then the new source file need to be compiled, right? They are residing in different locations. When you put the logically related class in one place, it is easy for you to manage. To some extent, it improves the efficiency, the code optimization. Okay, it's achieved. These are the three benefits we get out of inner class. The types of inner class. Types of inner class. The inner class is divided into two categories. One is non-static nested class and another one is static nested class. Okay, non-static nested class, static nested class. At this point, I want to raise one question. What is special about static members of a class? Students, what is special about the static member of a class? Static is a non-access modifier. It has got some special uses in a class. What is it? Can be invoked without need for creating an instance. Okay, very good. Any other way of answering this question? Your answer is correct. Can be invoked without need to creating an instance. Harish answer is correct. Can you give answer in another way? Other students can also think and try. Static member. The static member can be field or method. Now we are going to discuss a category called static nested class. So I want you to tell me a special feature about static members. Can be invoked without need for creating an instance. What it means? The answer is correct. I want to answer in another way. One more point can be added on this. No answers. Okay. The static members are accessible to every instance of the class. Very good, very good. It is the class property. Okay. All the instances can make use of the value of the static member. Okay. Example we have seen. If you have a student, his name may be different, register number may be different, but college will be different. Same, right? If it is for a particular college, college name will be same. So you can have a static variable named college name, store the value, right? That particular value is shared by all the instances of the class. Okay, all the students can make note of this point, right? Access to every instance of a class can be invoked without creating an instance, without creating an object. You need not to have object. Directly you can invoke the static member with help of class name. Very good. So in the types of inner class, we have two types: non-static nested class, static nested class. Okay, under non-static nested class, you have nested inner class, local inner class, anonymous inner class. So when anyone says inner class, they are non-static nested classes. Non-static nested classes are called as inner class. They are of three categories. One is nested inner class, local inner class and anonymous inner class. The other type under static nested class is static nested class, right? It is static. You will be defining a class with the static non-access modifier. A brief description about the sport type. Type nested inner class. A class created within class and outside method. You all know when you have a class, it can have method, field, constructor, etc. So in the inner class, another class can also be included inside a class, but that particular class should be outside the method. That is nested inner class. Local inner class. Okay, a class created within method, right? If you create a class within the method, we call it as local inner class. At this point, I need to have another question. What are the different types of variables in Java? Different types of variables in Java. Local, very good. Local, instance, static, Harish, very good. We have three type, local. So from, if you understand what is local variable, you can easily understand what is local inner class, right? A class created within method. Okay, instance variable, static variable, very good. The answer is exactly correct. Next, the third category, anonymous inner class. A class created for implementing interface or extending class, we call it as anonymous inner class. It is named by the Java compiler. We'll be making use of this inner class while overriding a method. The final category is static nested class. Static class created within class. Okay, every class is within another class, but locations are varying, right? One within the class, one within the class, within the method, another one with static keyword, one without name, right? So every class is inside another class. The types are four, right? The main category are non-static and static. All non-static nested classes are referred as inner classes. Okay, we'll see all the types in a detailed way. Types of inner class, nested inner class. Creating an inner class is very simple. You are going to write a class within another class, right? It is a nested inner class. Inner class can be private. Okay, we do not create any class with private access modifier because it becomes useless, right? It cannot be accessed by outside world. But you can create inner class with private access modifier. Okay. It cannot be accessed from an object outside the class. This point you know very well. If you make any member private, okay, those members are not available using objects. Okay, they are visible only within the class. Okay, the same condition for the class also, the nested class, inner class. A simple program to understand what is a member inner class, a class which is defined inside an another class outside the method, right? So class outer demo, we have outer class which contains a field number integer type. Now we have a class inner demo. We define an another class inside the outer demo class. We use the access modifier private. You can create class using private access modifier when we use inner class. In this class, a method, right, public void print system.out.println, this is an inner class. Okay, inside the inner class, you define a method with a print statement, you're closing your method, then you close the inner demo class. Inside the outer demo class, we have another method, void display inner. Okay, we are trying to call, okay, we are trying to call the method which is present inside inner demo, right? Opening the braces, you are creating the object of inner class, inner demo. Inner is equal to inner new demo, right? This is the way of creating the object. What is the other way of creating object? What is the other way of creating object other than new keyword? Yes, inner demo, inner new, inner demo is a way to create an object of a class. What is the other way? During the recap session, we have discussed. Students, are you all there? Clone, very good. Seriously, clone is the other way of creating the object. If you want exact copy of the existing object, we can go with the clone method. Very good. Here we create object of inner class and invoke the print method. Using the inner class object, we are invoking the method print. Close the method, close the outer class, right? Outer demo. So in this slide, what we have done, we have created two class. One is outer demo class, another one is inner demo class. Inner demo class is inside the outer demo class with a method print. Okay. The outer demo class contains a field number, a inner class, and a method display inner. Right. So now we are going to define a class which contains the main method, right? Public class. My class, public static void main string of, you are creating the object of outer class, right? Outer demo, outer is the object name, is equal to new operator, outer demo constructor. Then we try to access the method which is defined inside the outer class, outer dot display inner, closing the main method. Closing the main my class. Okay. If you compile and execute this program, you will get the message. This is inner class. Okay, the method that is given inside a method that is defined inside and another class. Okay. Here one point. Whether we can create object of the inner class inside main method, whether we can create the object of the inner class in the main method. Students respond, is it possible for us to create an object of inner class in the main method? No answers. The answer is very simple. Is it possible or not? Give me one word answer. Possible, not possible. Yes. Harish is giving yes. Okay, now we'll see the previous slide. Okay, now we have a class, right? We have a class inner. What is the access modifier we have used? What is the access modifier we have used? We have used private. If we use private, okay, they are accessible within the class. Okay, they are not available outside the class. Okay, now we have closed the outer demo here itself. Okay, the scope of outer demo is limited. The next slide, we have started with a new class named my class. Okay, the my class contains main method. Now you tell me, is it possible for us to create an object of type inner class? Okay, we have used the class name inner demo. Is it possible? No. Very good, very good, very good. Okay, so you need to make yourself strong in the access modifier. Okay, the basic concept. Okay, thank you. So students, please recap the access modifier topic, right, which you have discussed in the previous sessions. The next type of the inner class method, local inner class. Inner class can be declared within a method of outer class. Yes, okay, Harish. Now what you have to do is you have to learn from your mistakes. Okay, and the slides are projected for a few seconds only, so it is very difficult for you to grasp. So when you get questions in the question paper during the examination or any contest, read the question carefully and then answer. Okay, this is the point you have to learn from this situation, right? Okay, method, local inner classes. Inner class can have can be declared within a method. In the previous example, we have defined a class, okay, outside the method. So here we are going to define a class inside a method. This will be local type. Okay, local means we all know the scope of the class is going to be only within the method. Okay, outside the method, even in the outer class, you cannot, even inside the inner class, you cannot have access to the inner class, right? Third one, the method, local inner class can be instantiated only within the method. Okay, the instantiation is possible only within the method. So inner class can be declared within a method. Okay, the access of the inner class is within the method, and the instantiation of the particular class is also within the method. Okay, where the inner class is defined. A simple example to understand what is a local inner class. A public class, outer class. You students, you try to make use of your own program, because I have named all the classes method according to my convenience, right? There are about 170 students. So in a general way, I have used. When you have your own code, okay, let the outer class and inner class name be meaningful. Okay. Public class, outer class. We have a method, right? Void my method. You have a field named number of integer type, value 23. And another class is defined, right? Class method inner demo. I am defining this class inside the method inner demo with a print message using a print method, public void print. System.out.println. This is a method in inner class, and the number value 23. Closing the method, closing the inner class. Still the method is open, right? My method is open. We'll go to the next slide. Now we have two more statements inside the my method. My method demo is the inner class. Inner is the object. Is equal to new operator method inner demo. You can create instance of inner class within the method only. You cannot create object anywhere else. So we are creating the object invoking the print method, which is in the inner class closed my method. Within this, the scope of inner class is over. Nowhere else you can create object for the inner class. Now, public static void main string acts. The outer class, outer is the object name. New outer class, I call outer.my method. My method is the method which is defined inside the outer class. We are creating object of that. Using that object, you are invoking the method that contains a class with a print message that is internally invoked, and the message is printed. This is method inner class value 23. Okay, this is method local inner class. The anonymous inner class. The inner class declared without a class name is known as anonymous inner class. In the anonymous inner class case, we declare and instantiate at the same time, right? In case of normal class, you will define a class. You can also define an abstract class. You leave it. So whenever you want to have the features of that particular class, you'll create an object. You'll instantiate. Here in anonymous is declared and instantiated the same time. Okay. This is used for the purpose of overriding. You know what is overriding, right? The syntax for using the anonymous inner class. We are declaring and instantiating in the same location. You are including the members that you want inside the anonymous class. You see one important change. Okay, what is the change you find in the syntax? Let me enlarge this. Okay, what is the change you see in the definition of the anonymous class? Students, is there any change in the definition of the class when compared to the previous examples that we have discussed? Go through and no class keyword, okay. One more thing. You should remember this. How it terminates? Semicolon, right? Remember, you have to use semicolon to terminate your anonymous inner class. Here is the example, an abstract class. Abstract class contains an abstract method. Okay, we have discussed anonymous inner class is used at the time of overriding. So we are going to override my method, which is inside the abstract class. Public class, outer class, public static void main string args. Here we define our anonymous inner class. Anonymous inner is the object name, is equal to new anonymous inner. We have a method, public void my method. Here we are overriding the method which is in the abstract class, the beginning of the program, system.out.println. This is an example of an anonymous inner class. We are closing the method which is in the anonymous inner class. Close the anonymous class with a semicolon. We invoke inner.my method, right? Inner.my method. Inner is the inner class object. My method is defined inside that. The output is, this is an example of anonymous inner class. This is the third category of the inner class supported in Java. Static. I have said the inner class has got two types. One is non-static nested class and another one is static nested class. all non-static nested classes are called as inner classes, right? Inner classes. So static nested class. You all know about static keyword, right? Very well, you know what is the property of static keyword. The same is going to be applied for the inner class and is defined with static keywords. A static inner class is a nested class, which is a static member of outer class. A static member of outer class. We have discussed static field, static method. This point we are getting introduced through a static class. Okay, static class as the member. It can be accessed without instantiating the outer class using the static member. This is the static inner classes accessed without an object, right? Third one. Just like inner method, static nested classes does not have access to instance variables and methods of the outer class. This is the restriction. Syntax, class, my outer, outer class. Inside that, we declare and another class, class nested demo. We make it static by placing the static keyword, right? Static, open, close. Then you close your outer class. This is the syntax for static nested class. Okay, example, the static nested class. Public class, outer class, static class, static nested demo. Right? We are having an outer class. Inside that, we define an inner class. Name of the inner class is static nested demo. Before the class keyword, we have static keyword. So this is called a static class. This class is inside an another class, that is static nested class. We have a method, public void my method. Open the braces, system.out.println. This is my static nested class. You are closing your method definition. Close the static nested demo, the inner class. Inside the outer class, okay, inside the outer class itself, we define the main method, public static void main. Open braces. We are creating object of which class type here? Students, you tell me. The object nested is for which class? We have a statement, outer class dot static nested demo. Okay, it is for static nested demo, right? Inner class object. Okay, you need not to create object for outer class to access the inner class, because the inner class is static. Without the object, you can access. The static class becomes the property of outer class. It is common for all the objects. Outer class dot static nested demo. Nested is equal to new outer class static nested demo. We call my method, right? Using the object nested dot my method. Open close parenthesis. Close your main method. Close the outer class. Okay. then this program will give you the output. This is my static nested class and method. My method, okay, you have a my method containing the print statement with this is my static nested class. This is the fourth category of the nested class, broadly classified into non-static, static. Under non-static have three categories. Under static only common static nested. So when you are asked for the inner classes, you need to explain about all these things. Okay, the inner class, local inner class, static nested class, and the anonymous inner class, four types. Now we'll refresh our mind, right? Can you see the slide? Students, can you see the slide? Yes. Okay. See the color of each word. Okay, and you check how fast you can say it. You should not read the word, you have to tell the color. Is it possible for you to read quickly? Yes. Any one student have completed reading, respond. Completed. You say yes for completion, no for not completed. If I get any one yes, I'll move to the next slide. Okay, no one is responding, so we'll move to the next slide. Can you give the order? Okay, read the question. Five men were eating apples. A finished before B, but behind C. D finished before E, but behind B. What was the finishing order? Students, are you there? After this, we will continue. What is array list? So, in order to break, give a gap between inner classes and the array list, I have included this so that you get refreshed. No answers, students. Srivarshni, Vaishnavi, Harish, worked out? No one is responding. Can you see the slide?
Lama Bhattas are coming, sir.
I couldn't get you, Harish. Harish, you unmute and tell me again.
I can see a lot of answers in the chat box, sir.
Yeah, you can see. Okay, but I am missing. Okay, thank you. CABD, I missed. Thank you. All your answers are correct. Very good. Thanks for your responses. Next question. Your answers are correct. C, A, B, D, E. Thank you. Thank you for your answers. I see many new names, Vishnu Harshan, Andita, okay, Dina, Ritika will answer for many questions, Savinaya. Okay, the next. Can you guess the next three letters in the series? Okay. Leela Satvika. Thank you. Okay. Now we'll start with the next topic, array list. Okay, before discussing about the array list, you recollect the concepts that you have learned under array concept. How the array in Java is going to be different from the other languages. In array, in Java, array is going to be considered as an object, right? You create an array with the help of new operator. It's an object. You can store a fixed number of elements. You cannot grow or shrink the size of your array. You access the array elements with the help of the array index. When you try to access the index which is not allocated, you'll get array index out of bound error. Okay. So these are all the concepts you have studied under array. Now we will see how array list is going to help us. Okay. The answer for the question is ITS, you have replied, is correct. Okay, the first letters of every word in the sentence is taken to generate the series. Okay, array list in Java. Okay, what are all the features? Array list is a resizable array. If you use an array list object in your program, internally it is going to make use of array to store the elements, which is resizable. Also called as dynamic array. It grows its size to accommodate new elements. When you add a new element, it automatically expands. When you remove any element, it shrinks. Okay. Array list, not array, right? Array list has got this feature. It is resizable, it is dynamic array. It can expand on increasing the number of elements, and it will shrink when you remove the elements from the list, array list. Array list internally uses an array to store the elements. If you create an object of array list type, automatically it makes use of an array internally to store the elements. It allows the retrieval of elements using the index. Okay. Using the index, you can access the elements of array list. Array list allows duplicate and null values. Okay. It allows duplicate and also null values. Okay. You know what is null? What is null? What is null? Nothing. Okay, right. Null is nothing. When you have a reference, you will initialize the reference to null, right? When you create an object, if it doesn't contain any reference, you can initialize it to null. If you create a string object, you can initialize it to null. Okay, null has got different meaning in different areas. In Java, we use this to initialize the references. It has got different meaning in the other areas. Okay, the other areas in database, you have a different meaning in null. If you have null value anywhere, it indicates the value is missing or the value is not available or value is not applicable. In this case, we'll be using null. Array list is an ordered collection. It maintains the insertion order of the element. Internally, it has the representation, the order in which the data are inserted. array list cannot be created for primitive types. Okay, you all use array for the integer type, character type, okay, all primitive types. We have got 8 primitive types. For all the 8 primitive types, you can create an array. But array list can be created only for wrapper classes, okay, the boxed types, integer, character, boolean, right? So the wrapper classes object can be created for array list. Array list is not synchronized. Okay, already we have come across this term synchronized. It is one of the non-access modifier, right? Here it is not non-access modifier. It is a keyword used to refer non-access modifier, used whenever we have a multi-threading concept in our program, right? Here the array list is not synchronized. Okay, synchronized is the term. It is related to multiple threads, right? If multiple threads try to modify an array list at same time, the final outcome will be a non-deterministic. Okay, so it is not synchronized. So when we use multi-threading, at a point of time, multiple threads access the element from array list, okay, the outcome will be non-deterministic. Okay, so you keep in mind, when we read multi-threading, you divide, okay, when we use multi-threading in our program, you divide a single task into number of subtasks. Okay, multi-threading is lightweight process when compared to multitasking, right? Because the intercommunication thread cost is less, the memory used, okay, for the multi-threading is less. All the threads will be sharing a common area, so the cost is less. So multi-threading is the one that improves the performance of your application. It is array list or non-synchronized. So if you use while multi-threading, multiple threads access the element from array list, the final outcome will be a non-deterministic. These are the points you should remember when you use array list. Here is the class hierarchy of the array list, right? Here we have some terms, okay, inside the block, right? Iteratable, collection, list, abstract, array list. Okay. Array list is a class that extends array list. Okay, that extends array list, abstract list, that extends abstract list. Abstract list is also a class and implements the list interface. Okay, array list is a class that extends abstract list and implements the list interface. In the array list class hierarchy, iteratable, collection, list are interfaces, abstract list and array list are class. Okay, if you want to make use of array list in your program, you need to import java.util package to your program. Array list can be found in java.util package. If you want to have all the features of array list, you can include java.util.arraylist. If you want to have all the classes from util, java.util.star, right? Star means everything, all the classes. This is the class hierarchy of the array list. Constructors. Okay. I believe that you're strong in the constructors. If you define a class, you can write the constructor to initialize the fields. If you have the inbuilt class usage in your program, you can make use of the constructors accordingly. The constructors can be overloaded. So a class can have any number of constructors. Okay, the array list class consists of array list. Okay, array list without any parameter. Array list is the class name. So the constructor name is also going to be same. Array list, open quotes, the parenthesis is empty. It indicates it's a default constructor. It is used to build an empty array list. Okay, you are not specifying what is the capacity and all. So it builds an empty array list. Then array list collection C. It is used to build an array list that is initialized with elements of collection C. From the name collection, you can understand some group of items. You can create an array list. You can populate this array list with the values in the collection. Okay, so collection can be used as the parameter. Third constructor is array list with the capacity. If you specify the capacity based on that, the initial capacity of your array list will be decided. But keep one thing in mind, it is not fixed. The array list can expand on insertion and it can automatically shrink on removal, because we need to have some feature with efficiency, right? If something is fixed, if the size is 100 and if you have only 10 elements, it's not efficient. And if you have 100 location and if you have 150 elements, it's not flexible, right? So you should have both flexibility and efficiency so you can achieve it in the array list. Here is the simple example to understand how array list is created and how to add a new element into the array list. We have discussed that array list can be included into your program from the package Java and some package util. So import java.util.arraylist. Okay. List is another class, the second line, import java.util.list. Okay, we are not using list in this coding. We are using only the array list. We have array list in this code, right? Array list. In the place of array list, you can also use list. It also serves the same purpose. Public class create array list example. The class name create array list example. Main method, public static void main string of creating an array list. Okay, this array list is a generic one. It's a container, right? It's a collection. You can have this array list for any type of data, but this is not supported for primitive types. Okay, you can use it for the box type, the wrapper classes, right? In Java, string is an object that you are very familiar with. So the first example we have taken with the string object, right? Array list. Then the angle bracket, we specify the type string. Country. Country is the name of the array list. Country is the name of the array list is equal to new array list. Within the angle bracket, we specify string, right? The usage of string here is optional. You can leave the angle bracket empty. Okay, it will not give you any error. Constructor called semicolon. You are creating an object of type array string. Name of the object is country. Yeah, at this point, I want to tell you one thing. When you read any programming language or scripting language or any database software, you'll read syntax, right? If you read syntax, you will have some content within square bracket. What do you mean by the content which are given in square bracket? What is the meaning of the descriptions given within the square bracket? When you read the syntax in any area like programming language or database, if something is given within a square bracket, okay, it is optional. Very good. It is optional. If something is given angle bracket, if something is given within angle bracket, say for example, they would have given like this class, okay, space within angle bracket, they may be given class name, then open braces, close braces. Okay, it means that you can have your own name there. Okay, that is the meaning, right? You can have your own name. If you have class name with an angle bracket, instead of class name, you can use student, you can use employee. There you should not use angle bracket as such, right? You have to remove the angle bracket, use the name which is comfortable to you in the place where the content is given in angle bracket. Here in ArrayList declaration, we specify the type. Okay, here the angle bracket is must, right? You have to include the angle bracket to indicate the type of ArrayList. We have a method. It is the class. When I say class, it consists of methods, fields, etc. So we have a method add, right? Country is the array list name dot add. Within the parenthesis, you give the first element, India, right? You are adding the first element. Second, Japan. Third, Sri Lanka. Fourth, Germany. Four elements are added. I am using system dot out dot println country. Okay, country, it prints the content of the array list country. Okay, all the names you have added, India, Japan, Sri Lanka, Germany. Okay, students, in your notebook, you just note down what are all the method associated with array list we are discussing, right? Here we have started with add. Okay, add with one parameter the value. Okay, then what we do, country, add 2, Australia. Okay, here we have another add method which takes two parameters, one specifying the index, another one specifying the value. I am trying to include a new country name in the location 2. Okay, the array, as an array, the index starts from 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here you have no limiting. It will automatically increase. Okay, the system will take care of automatic expansion and shrinking of the list based on the addition and removal of elements. Okay, the system dot out dot println country, you are printing in the index 2, a new country, Australia, is added, right? Already you have India, Japan, Sri Lanka, Germany. Okay, you have Australia in the second position after the inclusion with index position, right? 0 is India, 2 is Japan, 1 is Japan, 2 is Australia. Okay, Sri Lanka, Germany. Okay, this is a simple program to illustrate the creation of the array list and adding elements into the array list. Okay, we have many inbuilt features to work with the array list. At this point, one question: if you have n number of elements in your array, how will you access all the elements? How will you access? Using for loop, right? Using for loop. Many inbuilt features are available in Java to access the array elements. Okay, here it's a simple example. So we are adding one by one and displaying the content. Iterators. Okay, the iterators are available. So you can use that feature to access. You can bring the output according to your convenience. It is the default way of printing the array list content. You can read, you can format in your own way and print. Okay. Creating an array list from another collection. Okay, we have seen three different ways of creating array list. Okay, constructor. This is an array list where we try to create a new list, add the elements from another array list. Okay. Import java.util.arraylist. Import java.util.list is not necessary for this program. if you have this in your code, instead of array list, you can use list. Okay, list. So if you use list, a list will be created. Okay. We are discussing about array list, so only that import is enough in this program. Public class create array list from collection example. Okay, name of the class. The name of the class is very lengthy. This type of name is not recommended. So I have used this name to explain. Okay, why I use this array list? This array list is used to create an array list and initialize, populate with the elements of another list. Okay, the public static void main string args. I am creating an array list. Okay, array list, within the angle bracket I give integer. Okay, integer is the wrapper class. You tell boxed type. You cannot have array list for primitive type. You fix this in your mind. First five prime numbers. First five prime numbers is the name of the array list. Okay, is equal to new array list, open close angle bracket, open close parenthesis, indicates a constructor, right? I add the elements one by one, right? First five prime numbers dot add two, first five prime numbers dot add three. Well, I repeat the statement again and again to include five prime numbers into the array list name first five prime numbers. Okay, this is one collection. Create an array list from another collection. Now I am creating another list, array list. This is also of integer type. First 10 prime numbers. First 10 prime numbers is equal to new array list of first 5 prime numbers. Okay, already I have a list named first 5 prime numbers. I have 5 elements in that. Second, I create another list named first 10 prime numbers. I populate it with already created list. Okay. Now, if you print the first 10 prime numbers, it will display 2, 3, 5, 7, and 11. These are the elements taken from the first 5 prime numbers. Okay. Next, we create the third list. Okay, array list, integer type, next 5 prime numbers is equal to new array list. Then I add 5 more prime numbers one by one, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29. Okay, and I am trying to add the third list content to the first 10 prime numbers. Right? First 10 prime numbers dot add all. Okay, add all. Then next 5 prime numbers. Now the list is created with already existing collection by including first 5 prime numbers. Next, I am adding all the elements of the third list which I have created into first 10 prime numbers. If you print, you will have 2, 3, 5, 7, 11 taken from the first list, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29 from the third list. All the elements are in the second list that we have created, first 10 prime numbers, right? So what are all the methods about array list we have discussed in this example? What are all the methods associated with array list are discussed? The associated methods are fast. Okay, add, add all, very good. Okay, add one by one, add all, it includes all the items of one collection to the another collection. Accessing elements from an array list. when you have a class, there are many members associated with the list. Import java.util.arraylist, the third program, importing ArrayList into your program. Public class access elements from ArrayList example, how to access the ArrayList. Main method, public static void main string args. Public static void main string args, creating an array list of string type. The array list name is top companies is equal to new array list, open close angle bracket, open close parenthesis, semicolon, right? Now a new list is created with the name top companies, okay? And you are trying to check whether the list is empty or not. This is done with help of a method associated with array list, right? The method name is empty, open close parenthesis, system.out.println. You are giving a prompt message, right? Is the company is empty? If the top company list is empty, you are trying to check the empty condition with help of is empty method. Top companies, the object you have created, right? The array list name dot is empty. You see, I is in lower case, E is in upper case. So in Java convention, right? Convention to name a variable and method. This using camel case. Start with the lower case. If it contains second, third, fourth word, we have to capitalize the first letter of each word, right? Camel case is empty using method associated with array list. What is the value that is written by this method is empty? At this instance, what is the value that is written by is empty method? We have an array list named the top companies. You are checking whether it has got some element using is empty. So what is the value that will be printed? Is empty is the method name. What is the possible value written? Okay, true, right? Very good, Chatrika, good. It returns either true or false. Okay, true or false. Here at this instance, program top company list, the elements are added, right? Next we try to add the elements. Top companies dot add Google, top companies dot add Apple, right? We are including the string values. Okay, all the company names we include one after the other using add method, right? Find the size of array list. Okay, now we are going to see a new method associated with array list. System.out.println. Here are top, the message will be printed as such. You are going to retrieve the number of elements present in your array list top companies. Okay, the method used here is size, right? Size. Top companies dot size plus concatenation operator, right? Within the course, if you companies in the world, so it will retrieve integer value. Okay, here are top 10 companies in the world. Okay, the message will be printed. Okay, what now? I want you to tell me what is in array. We don't have a method, right? We don't have a method to find the size of your array. What is the thing we have in array? How will you find the number of elements present in the array? Suraj, length, very good.
It is not method, right? It is not method, it is a member. So using array name dot length, you can retrieve the number of elements present in your array, okay, the array size. Very good, very good. When we use size, there is also another word called capacity, right? Can, in general, okay, in general, can anyone differentiate what is size and capacity? Size and capacity. We have come across the size, right? In array list, we use size. That tells you the number of elements present in the array list. We also have a method associated with string buffer class, string class, capacity. Can you distinguish in general? In general, you tell me what is size, what is capacity. Yes. Okay. We'll continue. If we receive any answer from students, we'll discuss. The system.out.println, top companies, number using the size method. Next, you print the top companies. The top companies list of print the capacities, how much it can hold. Okay, correct. That is maximum. And size is the how much it is present. Very good, Suresh. Very good answer. Thank you. Retrieve the element at the given index. We have stored, right? You are storing using the add method. You are checking using isEmpty. You are checking the number of elements using size. Now accessing elements using the index. Internally, array list makes use of index, right? Array to represent the elements. As in array, here also the elements are retrieved with the help of index. The method used here is get. Get the index. So best company will be in the zeroth index. So we are creating a string literal. String best company is equal to top company dot get zero. The first company is stored. Okay. Second, what we do, we take the second company from the index one. We may not know how many elements are present in the array list. Okay. How will you access the last element? You know, we have the method size that will tell you maximum number of elements present in your array. But the array index allocated to you is one less than that, right? So string last company is equal to last company dot get top company's array list dot size minus one. So you get, if you have five companies, size is five, the fifth company will be in the index four, so minus one. So you are retrieving the last company name and storing it in the variable last company. Next, you are printing, okay, the best company, the second best company, and the last company in the list based on the value we have retrieved from the array list using the get method with the help of index. Okay, you are printing. Now you see, we are modifying the content, right? We are modifying the content. Top companies dot set, right? Dot set 4, Walmart. We already have discussed about add, add all, size, get. Now we use set. Okay, you see how set and add will differ from each other from the output, right? Top companies set 4. Okay, when I say 4 means it's index. In the index 4, I am going to set a new value, Walmart. Okay. System.out.println modified company list. I am printing the content of the array list, top companies. Okay. With this, we are completing the program, right? The expected output. The expected output is like this, right? Is that company list is empty. It returns true. As you all answered, the isEmpty method returns true because we have created the top companies list. No companies are added into it. So isEmpty is true. Okay, then we are listing the top five companies in the world, right? Here are top five companies. Top, the value five is retrieved with the help of the size method, right? So 5 is printed. Company in the world is concatenated along with the size. The content of company list is printed, right? Google, Apple, Microsoft, Amazon, Facebook. Okay. Best company. Okay. Best company is retrieved from index 0. So when you see the output, Google is in the 0th index. It is taken. Second company, Apple. We are taking it with the help of the index 1, Apple. Last company, right? How we are retrieving the last company? We do not know how many number of elements in the list. So you are using size minus 1. So in the index 4, you have Facebook. Index 0, Google. 1, Apple. 2, Microsoft. 3, Amazon. 4, Facebook. Right? So from the 4th index, we are taking the last company. Okay? Then we have discussed about SIT. Right? SIT. So modified top companies list. If you see the output, we have Google, Apple, Microsoft, Amazon. If you use add, what will happen? If you use add 4, Walmart, it will include the Walmart in the 4th position. Facebook will also exist in the list. But here what we have done, we have used the SIT method. So Google, Apple, Microsoft, Amazon, instead of Facebook in the 4th location, Walmart is placed. Okay, it is replacing. Okay, so you have to understand the difference between add and set. Add and set. Now I want you to type the methods we have discussed related to array list. The methods that we have discussed related to array list. You type the methods. So for what are all the methods we have discussed related to array list? Add, okay, add, get, size, set, okay, add all, very good. Suraj has given all the answers. Satvika, Leela Satvika has also given partial answers. Very good, thank you. Then next slide, right? We have seen how to create, how to access, how to add, right? We should also know how the elements can be removed from the list. Okay. Java, import java.util.arraylist. We include a special function, right, from util package, right? Function.predicate. Based on some condition, you can remove the elements from the list, right? You can specify a condition and based on that the element can be removed. Instead of removing element from index 1 to 0, you can give some condition. If the condition is satisfied by the elements of the array list, those elements will be removed, right? So that particular feature is also added to this program. So public class remove elements from array list example, right? You can use any short name according to your program. This program illustrates the removal of elements. So remove elements from array list example is the class name. I'm defining the main method. The main method, you all know what is the syntax for creating the array list keyword, the type for which the array list should be created, array list name, right? So object is equal to new array list. Array list is created. Once the array list is created, we are adding. We are adding the elements one by one with help of add. We are not utilizing any iterators here. To understand the basic methods associated with the array list and the basic operations, we are repeating the instructions again and again, right? For programming language, add, okay, you are including C++, Java, Kotlin, Python, Perl, Ruby. Okay, you are adding 7 elements into the programming languages list. System.out.println programming languages. When you execute this statement, C, C++, Java, Kotlin, Python, Perl, Ruby. Okay, all the 7 elements will be entered in the output. Now we are going to see how the elements are removed, right? First, remove the element at index 5. As we are adding with the help of index and value, you can also remove the element using the index. Programming languages, remove 5, right? you are removing the element which is present in the index pipe. If you see the previous insertion, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all is in the index pipe. So after execution of this statement, programming language is dot remove file, perl will be removed from the list. So if you have your print statement, after remove file, you will have only 6 elements, removing the perl from the list, right? Next, boolean is removed. Okay, I'm declaring boolean is removed is equal to programming languages dot remove Kotlin. We can also remove the elements from the list using the value. If you know the value, using the value you can remove the element. Here we are declaring a variable is removed. It is not used. It will have the if the value present, Kotlin is present in the list, is removed will have true. If the element is not present, okay, it will have false, right? You can tell the element is present in the list, it is removed. The element is not present in the list, it cannot be removed. Such messages can be given to the user. We are not utilizing it. We are just retrieving the return value of the remove method and storing it in is removed, which is of Boolean type. After removal of Kotlin, again, we print the elements of the programming languages. Now, two elements are removed, one using the index, another one using the name. So you'll have 5 elements. 5 elements will be printed on the screen, right? Now we create the second list, array list, string, scripting languages, array list, string, scripting languages, new array list of construct, right? Adding elements to the scripting languages, Python, Ruby, Perl, right? 3 elements are added to scripting languages list. Okay. Now I write a method remove all, right? Programming languages dot remove all scripting languages. So it will take the list scripting language, compare the elements with the element present in programming language. If both are equal, it will remove all those elements. Now we have Python, Ruby. We don't have Ruby in the list, right? We have Ruby, right? Python, Ruby will be removed. Already we have removed Perl. So these two elements will be removed based on the instruction. Programming languages dot remove all scripting languages. Okay. Now condition, okay, I said you can remove the elements based on the condition you specify, based on the condition you specify. Remove all elements that satisfy the given predicate, given condition, right? Programming languages dot remove if new predicate string. Okay, the condition we are going to give based on the string value, okay? This is going to override the test method, but override public boolean test, which takes string argument, return yes dot starts with C. So if any item starts with the capital letter C, that particular element will be removed from the list, right? So this is removal of element based on the condition, remove if. Next, programming languages dot clear removes all the element, removes all the element from the list. After clear method, we are printing the content of the array list. Okay, now we'll see the output. Okay, output, the initial list with 7 elements, right? C, C++, Java, Kotlin, Python, Perl, Ruby. We remove the element Perl using the index. After removal of Perl, the element is printed second line. Third, based on the value, Kotlin is removed. Then remove all using the scripting language list. We have another list, compare it with the programming list, remove the element. So we have 3 elements finally, C, C++, Java. Then we write a removal condition based on predicate. we remove the elements that start with the capital C. So C, C++ are removed, only Java is present in the list. Finally, we are clearing the list using clear. It removes all the remaining elements, right? So this is a simple program to understand how the elements are removed from array list. Okay, so key points. Removing elements from array list. You can remove element using index. You can remove element using the value. You can remove element using another collection. We can remove element using given predicate. Remove if. Finally, you can clear the array list. It removes all the element of your array list. Okay. Ma'am?
Sir?
Yes, yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am,
you can address, ma'am.
Okay.